Hey everybody, Timcast here, and today I'm going to talk to you about international arms dealing. This is LAD, or the Latin American Aerospace Defense Convention in Brazil. It's just one of many international defense expos that happen around the world. At LAD, some of the world's largest weapons manufacturers show off their tools for defense. Now, the tools they're selling are exactly what you'd expect weapons manufacturers to sell, like bullets, guns, armor, drones, APCs, jets, and even rockets. But here's where it gets interesting. The single largest group of attendees to this International Defense Expo were police organizations, coming in at around 26% of all attendees. According to a study by the Stockholm International Peace Research Institute, world military expenditures, though still relatively high, have dropped by 1.7% over the past 4 years. According to the Homeland Security Research Corporation, they're expecting non-lethal weapon sales to double by the year 2020. At the same time, from 2014 till 2020, they're expecting internal security to grow by 56%. Just a few months ago, we heard that President Barack Obama was restricting some military gear going into the hands of local police departments. And while that sounds pretty good, it kind of means nothing once you actually look at what he's restricting. They banned armored vehicles that run on a tracked system instead of wheels, armed aircraft, ships, or vehicles, ammunition 50 calibers or higher, grenade launchers, bayonets, and camouflage uniforms. Yet they still allow airplanes, helicopters, drones, wheeled armored vehicles, tactical vehicles, 5-ton trucks, explosives and pyrotechnics, and riot helmets, shields, and extra large batons. So if international conflict is on the decline as well, can we expect to see a lot of these military tools end up in the hands of police? And then on top of that, more companies trying to sell less lethal weapons to these police? It seems like we just might end up in a situation where the police are stockpiled with tons of weapons, and it's just gonna create this huge disconnect between the police and the people, which already seems to exist, especially here in the United States. But what do you think? Is it a good thing that police are getting more less lethal weapons? Or does it just mean the police are gonna have more weapons? Does it mean that the police will be less likely to kill somebody? Or are these weapons just going to be used in the wrong way? Comment below and let me know what your ideas on the matter are, because I'm really interested to hear what all of you have to say. If you like the video, make sure to click the like button, share with a friend, and subscribe to my YouTube channel. You can also find me on Twitter at Timcast. Make sure to check out fusion.net for more awesome content. Thank you all so much for watching, and I will see you all next time.
A deeper well. My mother's the only one that works in our home, and it's something that's not possible, not just for us, but just for many families that are here.